Welcome to Tsunami Teacher USA's Tsunami Basics. This short video is intended to provide you with the basic understanding of tsunamis and how to protect yourself.
On the morning of September 29th, as you have asked, around 6 o'clock in the morning, they felt an earthquake occurred. Knowing from previous training that I had received as a mayor, he waited up in the higher area.
In the next several minutes, you will learn what a tsunami is, how to recognize dangerous tsunami waves are coming, and what to do if you are in a tsunami hazard or evacuation zone. Tsunamis are a series of traveling waves often generated by earthquakes. In the deep ocean, the waves can be up to hundreds of miles long, yet only a few inches or a foot in height. So, if you are on a boat in the deep ocean, you might not notice a tsunami wave passing beneath you. As they approach the shallow coast, the wave heights will increase, and in extreme cases can be up to 100 feet high when they crash on shore. Tsunami waves travel very fast in the deep ocean, somewhere between 400 and 500 miles per hour, which is the speed of a commercial jet airplane. In this animation of the September 2009 Samoa earthquake and tsunami, waves took only 10 to 15 minutes to reach the coast of American Samoa, Samoa and Tonga, and later reached California in about 10 hours.
Immediately we know, the earthquake is so strong that a tsunami may follow, and it's going to occur just like a blinking of an eye, so please head for higher ground.
A wave's energy can focus flooding inland along a road or up a river. Large debris such as cars and trees act as battering rams, causing destruction as the wave moves inland or recedes. The series of waves can continue to arrive every 5 to 60 minutes for several hours. The next wave can arrive before the previous one recedes, resulting in greater water heights and further flooding inland. The first wave also may not be the largest. These images give you an idea of what tsunami waves may look like to a person on the shoreline. The waves arrive as walls of water, not as typical breaking or curling wind or surf waves. At the coast, a tsunami wave will slow down, but the waves are still dangerous. This footage of the 2009 Samoa tsunami shows the ease with which a tsunami wave less than 1 to 2 feet high moved cars. Remember, even small tsunamis can be extremely dangerous to swimmers and boats in harbors due to the strong wave currents. If you see the ocean withdraw out to sea, exposing the ocean bottom, or hear the train-like roar of the tsunami, you might have less than a minute to get to safety. When an earthquake occurs near the coast, there may be only minutes before tsunami waves arrive. In this case, the natural warning signs are your alert to act immediately. Strong coastal earthquakes that shake for more than 30 seconds serve as a natural warning. Protect yourself first. Drop, cover, and hold on until the shaking stops. When it is safe, survey the area around you and evacuate by quickly walking inland and to higher ground. If wave arrival is imminent, consider vertical evacuation to the highest floors of a multi-story reinforced concrete building.
I looked down at the ocean and I saw the ocean was receding. It was going out. I could see the bottom of the ocean, the floor of the ocean. I knew then that the tsunami was coming.
These images show the first tsunami wave after it receded at Pongo Plaza. The next wave inundating Pongo Plaza arrived within 10 minutes of the preceding wave.
I could hear the wave was coming, and I felt it.
This is a video of a small tsunami generated by an iceberg breaking apart. You will notice small waves are generated, followed by a loud roar produced by the waves. The tsunami then lifts up fishing boats and relentlessly smashes them onto the shore.
Oh,
all coastlines are vulnerable to tsunamis. Make sure you know your community's tsunami hazard and evacuation zone. Walk your tsunami evacuation routes so you know where they are located. Remember, in a local event, the natural warning signs are your earliest and possibly only alert. The U.S.'s West Coast Alaska Tsunami Warning Center and Pacific Tsunami Warning Center are monitoring earthquakes all the time and will issue official warnings, but they may not be in time to warn for a local tsunami. So do not wait for the official warnings. Based on the tsunami's natural warning signs, act immediately.
Immediately we know, the earthquake is so strong that the tsunami may follow. And it's going to occur just like a blinking of an eye. So please head for higher ground.